Hi, I'm Dr. Zarowski from newvisionexcel.com, and in this video, we are going to be talking about a mineral called magnesium. We're going to talk about the signs and symptoms associated with a magnesium deficiency, the warning signs that you need to look out for, and then at the end of this video, what I will do is show you how to replenish magnesium and how to get it back into your diet. Now, magnesium is a mineral known as the relaxation mineral. And the reason for that is because it plays such a huge role in relaxing your cardiovascular system, your muscles, and also your nervous system. It's estimated that there's over 22 different medical conditions that come out of a magnesium deficiency. And it's estimated that only 25% of people actually get sufficient amounts of a magnesium on a regular basis. And then last, if not least, many of the experts estimate that 80% of people are deficient in magnesium. Now, the thing that's important to know about magnesium is that when you take a standard blood test, it likely will not show up on the test as a deficiency because less than 1% of the magnesium is free floating in your blood. So if you get a blood test and it doesn't show that you have a deficiency, many experts believe that you still likely do have a deficiency. And so that's why the warning signs of this magnesium deficiency are so important. So let's go ahead and talk about those. So the first warning sign that I want to talk about is how magnesium affects the mind. People who have a lot of anxiety, people who are really irritable, they're likely people who have magnesium deficiencies. Even kids who have different learning disorders and they can't focus and their mind's all over the place and they just can't calm down. Magnesium does a great job in just helping relax the mind as it relaxes the nervous system. Now, these same people who are very irritable and have a lot of anxiety also suffer from magnesium deficiency in the way that it affects their sleep. And the reason for this is because they have a hard time falling asleep at night because they can't turn their mind off. They also find themselves having insomnia and then they wake up the next day fatigued. And so magnesium deficiency also helps with your sleep. So if you're having bad sleep, look to that magnesium issue. Now let's switch gears a little bit because magnesium also really affects the cardiovascular system in a huge way. So if you're someone who has high blood pressure, if you're having arrhythmias or palpitations, or even someone who has heart disease, you really should look to magnesium because magnesium helps calm that cardiovascular system down in order to help it, heal and restore. And magnesium is such an important mineral to the heart because it plays such a huge role in the contraction and relaxation of the heart. Where calcium goes in and actually causes our heart to contract, magnesium causes our heart to relax. And so magnesium plays a huge role in the cardiovascular system. If you're suffering from any type of cardiovascular issue, definitely look to a magnesium deficiency. Now, the next big thing is the muscular system is greatly affected when it comes to magnesium. So if you're someone who's having cramping in your leg and cramping in your arms and just maybe who's even suffering from something like plantar fasciitis, then definitely look to a magnesium deficiency as it helps so much calm those muscles and causes the whole body to relax. The last thing I want to mention about magnesium is that it has a major effect on our memory. So, though it may be affecting your sleep and causing fatigue, and maybe you can even say that's related to the memory issue, but magnesium helps support a really good strong memory. So if you're someone who just finds yourself slipping in the way of not remembering things, look to magnesium because a deficiency in that can really affect the way that your mind is working. So a lot of people ask, why do so many people have a magnesium deficiency and where is it coming from? So the truth is it comes from several different areas. So one is going to be digestive problems. So if you have digestive problems, then there's a good chance that you're not actually absorbing the magnesium. If you have stomach acid problems, then it's the same thing. You're just not digesting it. Your body, even though you're consuming it, your body is not getting it. So digestive problems is a major one. The next big thing is people are not consuming enough leafy greens such as spinach. And even when we are consuming leafy greens, you have to realize that the mineral content of the food that we eat today, the vegetables that we eat today, is much less than it used to be 10, 20, 30 years ago. So you have to take that into consideration as well. And then, last if not least, stress is a major problem that depletes magnesium from our body. So if you're someone who's stressed out all the time, then that might be why you're having a magnesium deficiency. So when we look to replenishing it, you know, one of the best ways to get it back into your system is through supplementation. I recommend somewhere between 350 to 600 milligrams a day, just kind of depending, you know, what your needs are. So you can start out very light and increase it, but if you find that you're getting diarrhea from it, then you've gone too far. So you can go ahead and start with that. Supplementation is great. The other way that you can replenish your magnesium stores is to make sure you're consuming plenty of leafy greens. If you already have a deficiency, supplementation is really the best way to replenish the stores, but to maintain them, consuming a lot of leafy greens is a great way to do it. I hope that this video gives you the information that you need to get yourself well and to identify whether or not you have a magnesium deficiency. You know, I have so many people who can look at these different problems that I mentioned and they almost identify with all of them. So if you're someone who is identifying with some of these issues or, you know, maybe even all of them, then make sure that you're starting to supplement with magnesium, increasing your magnesium in your food, and then just working to fix the problem overall. So I hope that this video was incredibly informative to you. And if you find that you identify with many of these issues we talked about, then make sure that you're looking to magnesium in order to start finding some solutions to these problems. You know, sometimes I have people look at all these different issues I just mentioned and they identify with all of them. So if you're that person, then you certainly need some magnesium in your diet. And even if you identify with some, there's no harm in trying it and seeing if it causes some relaxation in that area and helps you solve some of these different problems. Go ahead and comment in the comment section below if you have any questions. Other than that, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and I look forward to making more content for you in the future.